Hey guys, in this new video, we're going to take a look at alpha decay. So remember, Rutherford talked about the three major types of decays. There's alpha decay, beta decay, and gamma emission. Here we have alpha decay. We're going to say alpha decay occurs when an unstable nucleus emits a particle composed of two protons and two neutrons. Now, just think about it. We say that our atomic mass equals the number of protons plus the number of neutrons. So here our atomic mass is, we lose two protons and two neutrons, so 2 plus 2 gives me 4. Your atomic mass is protons and neutrons added, and your atomic number is just the number of protons. So the number of protons lost is 2. So we're going to say the alpha particle is represented by 4 for your atomic mass over 2, your atomic number. And here we have our alpha symbol. Now we can also say that on our periodic table, we have an element that also has an atomic mass of 4 and an atomic number of 2. That element is helium. So we can say that the alpha particle can also be represented by the element helium, because helium has the same atomic mass as an alpha particle, and it has the same atomic number as an alpha particle. And remember, we're using the term decay. So decay means that this alpha particle will be a product. So if we wanted to look at an example of this, we could think of, for example, on your periodic table, you could have polinium, which on your periodic table is PO. Polinium, we're going to say, let's talk about isotope 210. Now remember, with these nuclear reactions, they can happen with different isotopes of an element. So on your periodic table, we'll be doing different types of decays with different types of isotopes. So don't worry if your atomic mass on your periodic table doesn't match my atomic mass. That's because I'm dealing with a certain isotope of that element. Remember, isotopes have the same atomic number, so they're the same element, but they have different number of neutrons, so they'll have different atomic masses. So here, polinium 210 means the atomic mass is 210. If you look on your periodic table, polinium has an atomic number of protons, of 84. Now, we're going to undergo alpha decay. Alpha decay means we're going to spit out or emit an alpha particle. You can represent it like this or like this. Here, I'll just choose to show it as helium. So we're going to emit 4 over 2 helium. Now, nuclear reactions are different from regular reactions, but there are some similarities. Just like you have to have a regular chemical reaction balanced, you have to have a nuclear reaction also balanced. So here, our total atomic mass is 210. Here we have already an atomic mass of 4. So we need to create an element that when I add it to the 4, gives me back this mass of 210. So the new element has to be 206, because 206 plus 4 gives me 210. Also, your atomic numbers need to match on both sides. This atomic number is 2. We need it to add up to 84. So we'd say that the new element would have to have 82, because 82 plus 2 gives me 84. And what element would that be? Well, that would be lead. So what we'd say here is that we'd say the alpha decay of polinium 210 creates a brand new element, lead 206. The helium or the alpha particle is just something that we emit that's just waste. The new element that we're concerned with is the lead 206. So this represents an alpha decay. And it's as simple as that. Make sure that your atomic masses add up on both sides. Make sure your atomic numbers add up on both sides.